I farmed in the country when I was a boy. A courting young Rose, she was my pride and joy. Rosie was pretty and just 17 when I showed her the works of me thrashing machine.
Thrashing machine, thrashing machine. I showed her the works of me thrashing machine.
Me that she was a much traveled girl, seen faces being places all over the world. But there was one sight that her eyes never seen, a vertical piston drive thrashing machine.
Thrashing machine, thrashing machine, a vertical piston drive thrashing machine.
We went to the barn and I took her inside and said, if you're good, I might give you a ride. It stood there all sparkly and shining and clean. She said, that's what I call a thrashing machine.
Thrashing machine, thrashing machine. That's what I call a thrashing machine.
Asked me to demonstrate how the thing worked, so I let out the clutch, the machine went berserk. You couldn't see nothing for the smoke and the steam when I started revving my thrashing machine.
Thrashing machine, thrashing machine. When I started revving my thrashing machine.
I said Rose could drive it for better or worse. The whole damn contraption went into reverse. The camshaft seized up, well, you know what I mean. Now that was the end of my thrashing machine.
Thrashing machine, thrashing machine.
Now that was the end of my thrashing machine. Oh, Mary is the girl for me, I love her more and more. Cause Mary always has a red light hanging on her door. Now Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was black as charcoal. And every time it wagged its tail, you could see its little eyes roll. Oh, Mary had another lamb, she kept it in a closet. And every time she let it out, it left a small deposit. Oh, Mary is the girl for me, I love her more and more. Cause Mary always has a red light hanging on her door. Oh, Mary stood on the harbor bridge, her knees were all a-quiver. The wind blew round the harbor bridge and then blew up the river. Mary danced across the floor, her dancing was fantastic. Then she bolted out the door, you just can't trust elastic. Oh, Mary is the girl for me, I love her more and more. Cause Mary always has a red light hanging on her door. Mary had a little watch, she swallowed it one day. Now she's taken castor oil to pass the time away. Oh, the castor oil, it didn't work, and the watch, it didn't pass. So if you want to see the time, just look up Mary's uncle. He's got a jeweler's shop. Oh, Mary is the girl for me. I love her more and more. Cause Mary always has a red light hanging on her door. Oh, Mary is the girl for me. There's not a girl that's truer. She was only a farmer's daughter, but all the horsemen knew her. Oh, Mary went out with a sword one night, a romance she was seeking. She missed his lips and she kissed his snout, and the bloody old thing was leaking. Oh, Mary is the girl for me, I love her more and more. Cause Mary always has a red light hanging on her door. A farmer that I know, he grew a big banana for the Royal Easter Show. And soon the story got around, they came from far and wide,
And when he showed them his banana, everybody cried, "Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh, what a beauty! It must be 2 foot long or even more. It's such a lovely color and it's nice and round and fat. I never thought I'd ever see one half as big as that. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before." He was leaning on the garden gate just the other day, and he beckoned to a lady who lived across the way. He took her down the garden path and showed to her with pride. And when the little lady saw it, this is what she cried.
"Hi, what a beauty!
I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh, what a beauty! It must be 2 foot long or even more. It's such a lovely color and it's nice and round and fat. I never thought I'd ever see one half as big as that. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before." Well, then the flower show was held and everybody went to see the big banana lying just inside the tent. And soon the judges came along to hand the prizes out. They only took one look at it and then the judges shout, "Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big as that before. Oh, what a beauty! It must be 2 foot long or even more. It's such a lovely color and it's nice and round and fat. I never thought I'd ever see one half as big as that. Oh, what a beauty! I've never seen one as big.
I've never seen one as big.
I've never seen one as big as that before." In the hills of West Virginia lived a gal named Nancy Brown. She was the fairest maiden for many miles around. And then she met the deacon, who was looking for some thrills. He took out little Nancy for a ride up in the hills. But she came running down the mountain, running down the mountain, running down the mountain, down the line. And she never gave the deacon that there thrill he went a-seeking. She came home as pure as West Virginia pine. Then came that village cowboy with his chaps and fancy frills. He took out little Nancy for a ride up in the hills. But she came running down the mountain, running down the mountain, running down the mountain by the shack. As I before have stated, she was still uncontaminated. She came home as pure as Pappy's applejack. Then Henderson the trapper, with his phrases sweet and kind, took her to the mountains, but when she read his mind, she came running down the mountain, running down the mountain, running down the mountain by the dam. And in spite of all his urging, she came home a local virgin. She remained as pure as West Virginia ham. Then came that city slicker with his $100 bill. Put her in his caddy and he drove her to the hills. But she stayed up in the mountain, stayed up in the mountain. She stayed up in the mountain all that night. She came home next morning early, more a woman than a girlie. And her pappy chased that hussy out of sight. Now she's living in the city, living in the city. Living up in New York mighty swell. She's now eating fancy victuals. She's all through with pots and kettles. And the West Virginia hills can go to hell. Things are so quiet in Texas since she got rid of Alexis. He used to keep till the dawn came in sight. He kept on making bang, bang all through the night. He was riding the range too darn often, so she laid him to rest in his coffin. She yanked out the bullets, sawed off his barrel. Now he can't shoot his pistol anymore. Their neighbors never bothered to go to the show. They'd stay around and wait for their own rodeo. It was only one gun that he toted, but oh my, how fast he could reload it. So she yanked out the bullets, sawed off his barrel. Now he can't shoot his pistol anymore. She always used to pray that someday she'd see him change. And she did one night, she found him riding with a Brown's range. He just could not get out of the habit. He was quick like a young prairie rabbit. So she yanked out the bullets, sawed off his barrel. Now he can't shoot his pistol anymore. He was rootin', he was tootin', he was full of foolish pranks. He was known as Sure Shot Daddy, and none of them were blanks. Oh my, he was so trigger happy, all the neighbors' kids called him Pappy. So she yanked out the bullets, sawed off his barrel. Now I'm sure in the sweet by and by, he's a ghost rider in the sky. How well I remember them last words he said. He said, what good's a cowboy if his pistol is dead? But she figured her life would be sweeter if she silenced his old repeater. So she yanked out the bullets, sawed off his barrel. Now she wonders, was it all for the best? She's haunted by an empty saddle that nobody cares to straddle. She's had no peace since she laid him to rest. Now just because you're pretty and you think you're mighty wise, you tell me that you love me and you roll them big blue eyes. When I saw you last week, your eyes were turning black. Go find the guy that beat you up, ask him to take you back. Don't roll and bloodshot eyes at me. I can tell that you've been out on a spree. It's plain that you were lying when you tell me you've been crying. So don't roll and bloodshot eyes at me. I used to spend my money to make you look real sweet. I wanted to be proud of you when we walked down the street. How darn us me to dress you up in satins and in silk. Your eyes looked like two cherries in a glass of buttermilk. Don't roll and bloodshot eyes at me. I can tell that you've been out on a spree. It's plain that you were lying when you tell me you've been crying. So don't roll and bloodshot eyes at me. I guess our little romance has finally simmered down. You ought to join a circus, you'd make a real good clown. Your eyes look like a road map, and I'm scared to smell your breath. You'd better shut your peepers before you bleed to death. Don't roll them bloodshot eyes at me. I can tell that you've been out on a spree. It's plain that you were lying when you tell me you've been crying. So don't roll them bloodshot eyes at me. Well, I've got a girl that I'm just simply mad about. People say that I'm a lucky boy. Everywhere we go, people rave about this little bundle of joy. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. And when she's in my arms, it's paradise. She smells just like a rose, from her head down to her toes. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. And when she's in my arms, it's paradise. All the sailors give her chase, cause they love her naval base. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. And when she's in my arms, it's paradise. She looks just like my Annie, from her head down to her fanny. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. She's got freckles on her butt, she is nice. And when she's in my arms, it's paradise. In a classroom, she's a loafer, but just get her on the sofa. She's got freckles on her. Ask me about a sister sometimes, she's a beauty. Take off your clothes, let me see what it is that you're hiding. And don't look so shocked, you have nothing to fear from my eyes. My daddy is a priest, you know, and I am not a beast, you know. I just want to look, yes, I just want to look. Take off your clothes and stand naked as nature intended. And I'll take off mine just to show that I'm in good faith. My daddy is a priest, you know, and I am not a beast, you know. I just want to look. Yes, I just want to look. Now you can see that it isn't as bad as all that. So lie on the bed and I'll talk of my unhappy childhood. My daddy is the Pope, you know, and I just want to grope, you know. I just want to love. Yes, I just want to love. But it will not hurt you, I promise you, that crossed my heart. The first time is always the best, you can ask anybody, ask your mother. My daddy is a priest, you know, and I am not a beast, you know. I just want to feel, I just want to feel. How can you say that I brought you here just for one purpose? There's thousands of girls I could get if I wanted just that. Yes, there are. My daddy is a priest, you know, and I am not a beast, you know. I just want to love. Ooh, I just want to love. How does it feel that you are no longer a maiden?
What do you mean? You want more. You want something now. Oh, my God.
My daddy is a priest, you know. And I am not a beast, you know. I just want to sleep. Yes, I just want to sleep. Take off your clothes, let me see what it is that you're hiding. Yeah. And don't look so shocked, you have nothing to fear from my eyes. Oh.
She's a crazy little witchy, and she's from the Murrumbidgee, and she's got a reputation far and wide. They talk about her east and west, they say her dancing is the best, so I thought I'd take a look and then decide. Well, it was down the Riverina, the first time that I seen her. Right then and there, my heart was in a whirl. She was dressed up to the nines and really looking fine. You've never seen such a pretty girl. Well, she's a crazy little witchy, and she's from the Murrumbidgee. You should see that little girl step it out. I tried to take her strolling, but she's keen on rock and rolling. She's the girl that all the fellas rave about. They say she took some beating at the dance hall down in Leeton. The gang stood back and gave her all the four. Her jeans, they were the tightest, and she danced just like some vitus. The fellas all were yelling out for more. Well, she's a crazy little witchy, and she's from the Murrumbidgee. You should see that little honey step around. Her charm, it never fails. She's the queen of New South Wales. She's the heppest little cat in all the town. Well, she really looked fantastic when she busted the elastic in her ponytail, and ow, I had to frown. I asked her what she's selling, but it's just her way of telling she's really gonna let all her head down. Well, around about this particular time, we got together, we were doing fine. I had dreams of making her all mine, you see. Then one day, some real cool cat came all the way up from Ballarat, took my Murrumbidgee witchy away from me. I'd like to tell you fellas who are in the prime of life, you're getting old, son, you're getting old. If your nerves have had it with your dear sweet nagging wife, you must admit it, you're getting old. If once you walked up flights and stairs with quite a lot of ease, and now you get all wheezy crawling up on hands and knees, and you've given up your reading all about the birds and bees, you're getting old, son, you're getting old. If the girls have gone in swimming, but you'd rather stay inside, give up hope, son, you're getting old. Or if they're playing games and postman's knocked you, run away and hide, you've had your chance, son, you're getting old. If you're on an ocean liner with the girls upon the deck, and later end in hospital, a worn-out broken wreck, cause you tried a double somersault, you broke your flaming neck, you sure have had it, you're getting old. Just can't get on the telly, but you'd rather have a smoke. Just keep on smoking, you're getting old. When you told an naughty story and you just can't see the joke, there ain't no joking, you're getting old. Do you like to have some fun with your wife when she's not near? Do you plant a frog inside the bed while she's drinking all your beer? When she comes to bed, pops inside and says, is that dear beer? You're getting cold, son, as well as old. When your sunken chest has slipped and it is
dragging on the ground. You've done your bit, son. You're getting old. Every time you take a deep breath, your pants keep falling down. It can't be helped, son. You're getting old. When you try to jump the mud hole and get bogged down in the slime, or if you're racing to get somewhere and you don't get there in time, and you've really dropped your bundle, babe, it's time to fall in line. Old Nick is waiting. You've got to owe. I have a little tale to tell about a Scottish lad. He won all the ladies' hearts with the talent that he had. Big Mac was a brawny lad, his manner it was charming, but the tilt in his kilt was really quite alarming. Is nothing worn beneath your kilt, asked the parson's daughter. Nothing worn, said Big Mac, it's all in good work and order. Big Mac was a handsome man, the girls all gathered round him, because the tilt in his kilt was really quite astounding. He stood upon the harbour bridge, the cold wind it was blowing. He didn't know where it come from, but he knew where it was going. Big Mac was a happy man, he had a sense of humor, but the tilt in his kilt surely was no rumor. Big Mac's good friendly Diane said, there's one thing that I crave. Mac, my friend, will you pour a bottle of whiskey on my grave? Said Mac, I'll gladly do it, lad, but you know of my great thirst. So do you mind if I strain the stuff through my kidneys first? Big Mac was a happy soul, kind and warm and gentle, but the tilt in his kilt sent the ladies all quite mental. Now Mac is a man that you may see, he's tall and strongly built. You'll recognize him right away by the enormous tilt in his kilt.